Hey friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey and I'm a web designer. Today I want to share a clip from my weekly office hours session that I host in the Creative X crew, which is my free community for professional designers and developers, freelancers and founders. During these sessions, I answer questions, provide design feedback, live coaching calls, and I also host lectures and workshops, all with the sole purpose of helping you succeed as a designer. If that sounds like you, join the crew. The link is down below in the description and the pinned comment. Without further ado, cue the clip.
Totally different subject. Yeah. The other thing that's kind of been capturing my attention is this whole like OpenAI chat thing. I'm sure you've seen that.
Yes, I did see that. Amazing. You say amazing?
Especially, you know, thinking about understanding code, for example.
Yep.
You know, some people would say this is going to replace developers and blah, blah, blah. It's going to code for you. And I don't really see that. I see it as a better way of understanding code. Because if it has access to like all the documentation for the languages and frameworks that you're using.
Yeah.
This whole conversational interface
mm-hmm.
Will help you understand it better. It's like, you know, you can say, you know, show me an example using this library of how you would do some sort of API request or something like that. And it can, you know, and it'll draw from the documentation and it'll explain it to you in English and not just throw like documentation at you. You know, because sometimes documentation is like, here's a function and here are all the things that you can put as arguments into it. And without necessarily understanding, like, what is this used for? What does a return object look like? How can I integrate this? Like, whereas this can actually, you know, you can, it understands what you're asking.
Yeah.
And it'll show you an example and you can say, okay, well, using that example, can you rejig it to accomplish X or Y? And it'll do that. Like it's pretty outstanding.
Yeah. I think the conversation about AI and the ethics around it, I think it's in development and it's also being revealed over time, the implications of it. And if like, I'm still on the fence in certain capacities because I don't think I can see far enough ahead to know how great this could be or how catastrophic it could be. Because I'm not quite sure, you know, like I'm still open. Like, my mind is yet to be decided on it, but, and I can see good and bad sides. Like I'm happy to talk about, this is why I think it's really bad. And also this is why I think it's really good. So in that scenario, like, I think it's really good. And so I like to look at it through the lens of like, why is that good? Is that ethical? Is it what's bad? Like I look at it through that, like a couple steps forward. I try to. And so when you're saying like, no, it's not replacing developers, like, just as, I don't know, like asking, like when I'm learning code, you know, when I was learning, let's say PHP, like I relied heavily on asking the backend developer at the studio or the programmer in school that was like really smart, like heavily, like annoyingly so, I would say, sorry, how do I do the dynamic like date again? Or what's the right, what is this a global function or is this like an internal, what is this called again when you do the function inside the thing so that you can't reach it out here but it's in here, what do you do that, how do you call that again? And then they'll like all right, well it's called this, this is how you do it and this is how you declare it. I'm like, okay, good, got it. Now how do I make it so that it works on the other page? Like I would just ask these really basic questions, right? And you keep doing that and they're answering it for you, just the same as I relied heavily on like Stack Overflow and these like forums, like how do I do this in, you know, JavaScript or PHP? And then you'd see the code snippet, you'd look at it, you'd see the comments, you'd copy it, you'd paste it, you'd like debug it, you'd try and figure it out. What this is kind of doing is like taking the collective knowledge of what you're doing anyway, like that's not replacing developers. Forums aren't. The developer buddy that you have that's willing to answer all your stupid questions. That's not replacing developers. Like it's just a way for you to learn it. And so, man, if I had access when I was learning these things, like I probably would have saved a lot of heartache for these like buddies and coworkers and a lot of unsuccessfully combing through like forums and stuff, if they could just collectively find that knowledge on these forums and formulate it in a way that I understand, that just like, it just makes way more sense. I just think it empowers developers and younger developers, new developers, or older developers who want to learn new ways. It just makes it easier. I don't know. It's like utilizing AI for what I think it's really meant to do, which is to like serve like the human need for certain things. You're like, can you help me do this? Can you help me figure this out quicker? You know, and like, yeah, like I'll spare you all the Googling and all this and all that, and I'll just serve it up to you in a way that, because I can search the internet faster than you can. Like, yes, you can. So do that and get me the best answer and help me understand it so I can, as a human, do my part. I think that would have been great. It would have, like, I think that makes it even better for developers. That's, I think. I'm just on OpenAI chat right now, just typing a thing in.
Yeah, like one example that I did was like, if I was building a static web, like you sort of set a scenario for it, right?
Yeah.
If I was building a static website, how can I use lemon squeezy to, or how can I limit access to a page with user authentication from lemon squeezy? And then it just served up like an example that it cooked up from the documentation. You know, here's the API call and here's the JavaScript, how the JavaScript would look. And yeah, there you go.
That makes sense to me. It's like code is just a program and robots are a program. It's like putting a layer on top of the program. So learning how to code, like that's just robots is all that is. It's just ones and zeros. It's just bits and bobs. That's robot. We're just learning that, you know, we invented that and we learned that. But it's like putting an interface on top of it that you can communicate with and go, how do I do this better? Or how do I do that? Or what's the way to do that? So communicating in a human way that the AI can understand and then give you the version that you can understand. So it's like, it's like a translation in between versus like getting really good at like searching through documentation or, you know, it's just, it makes a lot of sense. It's like this whole AI art thing. Everybody's seeing, everyone's posting their profile picture that was like painted in AI using that Lensa app or whatever it is. And everybody's showing these like really like epic versions of themselves painted by AI. And it's kind of like things like, you're like, whoa, like I couldn't draw that digital art myself and I have to pay an artist, a digital artist to do that. But this just does it instantly and it looks awesome. It's like, is that going to replace a digital artist? Is that going to mean like, now we can write copy in AI. So AI can write copy for us, sales copy. It can write YouTube videos for us. It can do all this stuff. AI can do a deep fake and take my face, my voice, and my likeness and create a video of me saying AI words in my voice. And then like, you're like, so what's the point? What's the, you know, what are the ethics of that? Obviously that's like, that could be very bad. But I think like humans need humans. When you show me AI art, and then especially as we move forward, we'll probably have to make disclaimers of like, this was augmented with AI, or this was created by AI, or this was researched by AI. Well, like those things I think will inevitably have to be in place so that we're not deceived, being deceived by people who use AI for malicious purposes or for to lie or whatever, plagiarize, I don't know. But it's like, if you created art and it was great, and then AI created art and it was, let's call it great, objectively. Eventually, once we get over the, wow, that was just automatically created. How cool, we don't need people anymore. Eventually you'll get over that and go, oh, am I just reading a book created by AI? We're like, I don't care. Like, this is not a real person. There's no human here. There's no humanity. There's no creativity. There's no experience. There's just like the collective internet wisdom put into some sort of like version of it. Like that doesn't matter. Like it doesn't connect. But I think there are parts where it really will matter. Like if you're mocking up a site and you need a wireframe for a site, or if you wireframe something up, you're like, I want it to be kind of like this. Feed it to an AI image translator that creates like a basic mockup in Figma. It's definitely going to happen if it's not already a thing. Does that mean that we don't need like UI designers to create nice Figma mockups from our wireframes? No, it just means that now they'll kind of get to hit the ground running and go, hey, here are the concepts that we generated using AI. I kind of like these directions. Let's work with this direction. And now you need to refine it and actually make it real and make it serve the need of the client or whatever the project is. It just kind of gets you up and running quicker. And I think that that's just inevitable. You know, just like automation has always happened in the past. You're like, we don't need 1,000 people on a conveyor belt like doing manual processes when you could just get the robotics to do it for you way better, way more efficient, and everybody's happier and safer on the back end. Now all these people lost their jobs, but like it was inevitable that was going to happen. So how do we find a way to reposition these people in places where they can be of more value? Same with designers. We're just designing things that like you're iterating on an icon when you could be like doing a higher value design task. Like when AI can just like, give me 100 variations of this icon of a rocket ship. It'll go brrrr, and you're like, wow, this is way better and more time efficient. But now that designer can focus on something better, you know, on something that requires creativity, that requires a human, that requires specialized skill, nuanced skill, better communication. You know, maybe the designer who's not doing all the icon design, they're communicating with the client, but they understand the language of AI and they could utilize that to help produce work, refine it, and then communicate it back to the client. I just think it makes it just creates opportunity that I think we're still trying to figure out. Thanks so much for watching that. If you liked it, tap the like button and consider subscribing to the channel so you don't miss any of our videos. And if you loved it and want some more, join us in the CreativeX crew. While you're here, why not check that video out? Cheers.